There are not actually many peatland sites in the world where CO2 fluxes are being measured. One reason why we are measuring carbon fluxes here at this peatland is to see how the carbon exchange might develop into the future with climate change. As the vegetation grows, it takes up carbon from the atmosphere and stores that in the peat below. We are here at Auchencorth Moss, the ICOS station, the only ICOS ecosystem station in the UK. What we are finding here is that a more important driver is how severe, how cold the previous winter was dictates how much carbon is stored in the next growing season. The danger is that as the peatlands, for example, get potentially drier or temperatures are getting warmer with climate change, that they might then burn off more carbon and release some of the carbon back into the atmosphere. So that the peats, which have been growing over the years and been taking up carbon, might become a source of carbon. Now, whether a long-term trend, whether that would be maintained, is uncertain, because changing climate could also change the vegetation, which might then actually act differently. This used to be drained to some extent 200 years ago. And in places in Scotland, peat is still being harvested as a fuel source. So people still burn it in their stoves and open fireplaces. So although we are fairly close to Edinburgh, about 20 kilometers away, it's quite a remote feel, significantly rougher than in Edinburgh itself at the coast. But there are days where we just can't get here at all, just because it's just too windy to work out here. I guess Scotland is somewhat famous for its harsh weather at times.